Thank you. enthusiastic this morning?
Amen.
And who woke you up this morning?
Amen.
Fired up. With who?
With Jesus.
Man, that's a fired up with who?
Jesus.
All right. You gotta wait for the introduction to go in there. Get into it. But while we're waiting, page 10 in your hymnal. I love page 10. And I'm bringing the mic today. Pastor Sacker uses his mic. Come around and hear you guys, hear your voice, okay? So, sing it for the Lord, Tom, man. Sing it for the Lord. Yeah, say Tom, he's looking right through. You all right? All right. Page 10, huh? You can't sing. You can squeak. As long as you squeak, you can sing. Page 10 in the hymn. Amen. Need your voices this morning. Sure enough. He treats us right. He woke us up this morning. Amen. We've been someplace else. The mic in your hand. Look, he's back to back. He think I'll come bring that mic. Come and bring that mic. I'll bring the mic.
Amen.
Page 10. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I hate those you're looking at me. I'm in trouble.
No, you're not.
Not yet.
Oh, how I love him. Amen. There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing his word. It sounds like music in my ear. The sweetest name.
Let us rejoice and be glad. Can we pull the reverb?
reverb down. Turn the reverb down.
Amen. Amen. For this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to go before the Lord in prayer. Kind Father, now in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. Thank you for this day. Thank you for brand new mercies that you gave us on this morning. Father, we thank you for another uprising, God. Thank you for another chance at what we call life. Thank you for brand new mercies that you gave us this morning, God. Your word says morning by morning, brand new mercies we see. It's because of your compassions that we have failed not. Father, you have given us another chance and another opportunity to sing your praises, oh God, to live this life, and to also to get it right, oh God.
Yes.
And God, we come in this room for no other purpose but to praise your name.
Praise the Lord. Praise.
Father, we forget what happened on last week. We forget about what happened on the job. We forget about what happened in the home.
Yes.
And Father, we have assembled in this place for one purpose alone, and that is to say thank you.
Thank you.
God, we've come to lift our hands. We've come to sing our praises. We've come to hear your word, oh God.
Yeah.
God, we've come to just merely say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We say thank you for life and health and strength. Thank you, oh God, for food, raiment, and shelter.
Yes.
Thank you, God, for the activities of our limbs.
Yes.
And being clothed in our right mind. Now, Father, in Jesus' name, God, we pray that as we're in this room, that you would be in this room with us, oh God. God, we pray right now that you would get into every song.
Yes.
Get into every prayer, God.
Yes.
People that are coming in that are heavy burdened, oh God, and that are downtrodden, oh God. Send your strength to them right now. Touch the priest and the prophet of this house, Dr. Derrick E. White. And God calls him to preach your word with power and conviction.
Yes.
Thank you for this choir, God. We pray that they will sing your songs of Zion, oh God. Oh God, with power and with anointing.
Yes.
And Father, we pray that you will fill this room with your glory, oh God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray that every baptized believer lift their hand to say amen.
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 Amen. Show me your Bible, Proverbs, please. Proverbs 16. Proverbs 16.
Thank you. morning, church.
Morning.
Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measures, pressed down and shaken together and running over. Luke 6:38. Praying the Lord's blessings, your giving heart in abundance measures. Thank you. For my Mount Olive family, Sister Brenda Gerald.
Amen.
That happens after prayer. Just a reminder of the NAACP chapter, we'll be having the rally.
Amen.
On February the 17th, that's a Saturday at 4 o'clock. Reservations is closed now. A reminder on Sunday, February 25th, we will have our Black History Month luncheon. So there is a sheet out, so we're hoping everyone can please bring a dish. We're proud to announce our pastor's 10th anniversary.
Amen.
Celebrating it this year. Please join us as we give thanks to God for the blessings he has sent us. Reminder that the planning team meets every Wednesday at 6 o'clock here at the church. There are sign-up sheets out, and they need a lot of volunteers. So if you're willing and able, please sign up. The title for this year is a divine assignment for a dedicated servant. Scripture is Acts 20:28. It will be Sunday, May the 19th. The colors are royal blue and gold. The speaker is Reverend F.D. Sampson. And we will have different events throughout the week.
All right.
With the outing, fish fry, and the banquet. Do we have any visitors? Would you like to give your name?
White only. His mother said these signs were in all southern cities and towns in the United States. Every time Martha read the words, he felt bad until he remembered what his mother told him. You are as good as anyone else. In church, Martha sang hymns and read from the Bible. He listened to his father preach these words, made him feel good. When I grow up, I'm going to give big words too.
Amen.
Martin grew up, he became a mistress like his father, and he used the big words he had heard as a child from his parents and the Bible.
No.
Tell them that.
Everyone can be great.
Tell them that. Amen.
He studied the teaching of Mahatma Gandhi. He learned how the Indian nation won freedom without even firing a gun. Martin said love when others said hate.
Amen. Tell them that.
Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that.
Amen. Amen.
My name is Izzy.
Plus churches in this area, and we're honored today that you are here so we can rub shoulders with you. If you don't have a church home, we're more than happy to have you unite with us.
Amen.
And if you're looking for one and don't want to be part of this one, then we can refer you to a Bible teaching church from our friends from around the area. We just want you to be have a good fellowship to be in, because if it's right to be in church, is wrong to be honest. And then I want to encourage us, the music will coming. Now all night activities from the 12th to the 16th will be shut down, which means Wednesday night Bible class. We won't meet that night. It'll be shut down because we want to commit this week to practice. Now the morning classes will still go on, but the night classes won't. And I want to encourage all of our members who are going to be part of the choir to come and support. Pastor Washington is coming every night, all week.
All right.
And back and forth to Dayton.
Thank you, sir.
And we at least ought to come across town.
That's right. That's right.
So we need to be here. He's making a huge commitment. He has a family. He has things he's got to take care of. He got mouths to feed. He got, Jeremiah, what, a year? Two year old son. And, so he's got things happening as well. And so we need you to make the commitment that week to be here. And then we're going to have the grand finale on that Sunday. And then the third Saturday, which is the 17th, the General Baptist Association winter board meeting is going to be here. Starting at 10 o'clock, so we can twist our arm of the people we love so much, by the name of Rochelle and her crew. We can twist their arm for about 15 to 20 people, maybe that many, to have some kind of little snackaroo going on, whatever. We'd appreciate it. And let us worship. Amen. Today is a beautiful day, and we want to give God all the praise and thanksgiving. He's been good to us.
Amen.
We need to. One of the things I love about my life, we ain't ashamed to praise.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. When we go to Richmond games, when Richmond plays Centerville and beat Centerville, it got so loud a couple of times I had to kind of put the fingers in my ears. And I don't know when they play Kokomo Friday. I understand it's already sold out, or will be sold out if you'll get there in time. And there's going to be some loud cheering just watching a ball go through a basket. And hopefully Richmond has more going through than them. Dr. J.C. Wade Jr., who's been here, Carrie's pastor when she was in East Chicago, he's been here a couple of times, said a
one of the people came by his house and just unannounced. He said, I've been bothered by something. Pastor Wade, he said, what's that? He said, well, he said, every time you preachers preach, you always say Jesus died. And then he got up on Sunday morning. He said, I don't understand why you keep saying the same thing over and over. He said, well, let me talk to you about that. Let me answer that question in this way. He said, when you go to a football game and you see the team score a touchdown, what do the people do? They cheer, they're excited. So when you go to the basketball game and watch them score the hoop and your team wins, what do you do? He said, they cheer. He said, why do they cheer? He said, because they have got the goal. They've met the goal. They've hit the shot. He said, that's what crowd three is. It's the goal. That's the goal. As you know, you already want to hear that at some point. Amen. That's just how it is. That's the goal for the believer. And you got to be careful because we're in a day where people ain't trying to reach the goal. They're trying to accommodate sinful behaviors of folk and say that, that quote-unquote a certain kind of person needs their own space to do whatever they want to do. No, it don't work that way.
That's right.
You know, it don't work that way. The Bible is gives us the way we ought to live and what we ought to do. And if you're not complying with that, then something needs to be said up to you about it so you can change. But we're not going to change stuff in here to accommodate somebody when it comes to coming in after the food. And we just need to know that because there's some stuff getting out in the world and it's taking hold in a lot of areas. And we just need to make sure we're solid because it'll be in Richmond soon. I remember I was talking about same-sex marriage when I moved back here from California, and Lauren said, oh, that ain't coming to Richmond. I said, yes, it is. A few years later, here it came. So there's a lot of stuff going on. We love everybody. So it's not like, you know, we love you, but you're not going to come here and dictate stuff that ain't got nothing to do with the Bible. And we love you. And I'm not mad at nobody. I'm just talking about what I'm talking about. Amen. God bless you.